Today on Warrior
Update.
What? What are you doing?
I'm hosting the show.
Oh, no.
First episode. This is my big shot.
Everybody knew I was going to host the first episode. It's kind of like a...
Everybody except Winesec, because I'm sitting here right now.
We've planned this since, like, the beginning of time.
I've planned this since last year. I'm the genius that came up with felt-tip pen. I get another shot.
I mean, nobody even liked the felt-tip pen
joke.
Everyone
loved the felt-tip pen
thing. They made fun of you for, like, a week.
Settle this like men.
All right.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Good.
On three. Dude, can I just host?
Oh, yeah, sure.
All right, you get it next week, though.
Cool.
All right, cool. Today on Warrior Update, we preview homecoming week. Football kicks their season off to a great start. Freshmen tell us their best and worst about Waubonsie. And we remember the tragic events of September 11th, 2001. It's Friday, September 9th. I'm not Martin Petritis, and you're watching Warrior Update. Waubonsie Valley football has started the season 2-0. Going into Bartlett tonight, Warrior Update has more.
Waubonsie Valley football jumped out to a fast 2-0 record this year, having beaten both Naperville Central and Oswego. The team attributes its early success to quickness.
So far, our team's built on speed this year, so I think we got a lot of speed coming at us, and other teams aren't ready for that.
We have a lot of speed. I guess we use that. Our wide receivers are really tall and have a lot of size, so that it gives us a good matchups against the defense. And then
our goal is to get 11 guys to the ball every play. We like to swarm tackle. With that, you can get strips and stuff like that, and our speed is based off our coverage too, so we can cover the offensive guys really well.
A new defense in 2012 has allowed only 10-plus points per game.
Coach Griff, he put in a new defense this year, which is, we call it our Joker, which is we have a 3-5 with one safety over the top, which really helps out the run game, and then we play man-to-man coverage. And then we have myself, which is the free safety kind of roam, which gives us a new look, and which offenses aren't ready for.
The Warriors' spread offense has averaged just over 27 points per game.
We have a pretty good running game with Guido, because he was a starter last year as a sophomore.
It starts with the line. They set the tone. And without them, nothing happens. They're the primary of the offense. So, yeah, it starts with them. I'd say we're a spread offense, so mostly pass. But we still have a handful of run plays. So we only have one running back in the backfield.
Camaraderie among players has helped the team's early accomplishments.
This year we're a lot closer as a team. With lifting in the mornings during the off season, it really brought us together, and I think we're a lot closer for that.
A lot of the guys are really close. It's really team effort, and we're basically family on the football field, and everyone knows each other, and we get along really well.
For Warrior Update, this is Scott Search.
What is your profession?
every day I'm shuffling.
Step up fast and be the first girl to make me throw this cash. We get money, don't be mad, now stop. Hating is bad. One more shot for us, another round. Please fill up my cup, don't mess around. We just want to see you shake it down. Now you home with me, you're naked now.
If you see some new faces in the building, that's because they're freshmen. We decided to talk to some of them to see how the start of their school year went.
Have you gotten lost at Wabanzi yet?
Yeah.
Where?
Upstairs. I got lost trying to go to the third floor.
If you could change one thing about Wabanzi, what would it be?
Have all their stairs go to the third floor.
And what is the worst thing about Wabanzi?
Have only one stair to go to the third floor.
It's complicated.
If you could change one thing about Wabanzi, what would you change?
I'd give it a map.
Have you gotten lost at Wabanzi yet?
Yeah, actually I did get into the cafeteria. I walked the wrong way.
Alright man, if you could change one thing at Wabanzi, what would it be?
Make it smaller.
What's the best thing about Wabanzi?
Meeting new people. I've met a lot of new people so far. The teachers have been pretty nice. I mean, it's pretty seeing the different personalities that teachers have.
We meet new friends.
Yeah.
What's the worst thing about Wabanzi?
There's a lot of tall people.
Yeah, really tall people.
Like really tall.
What's the worst thing about Wabanzi?
Homework.
If you could change one thing at Wabanzi, what would you change?
Less homework.
Have you been teased by any seniors yet?
Yeah, sophomores, juniors, seniors, teachers, subs, friends, parents, 7-Eleven workers, and pets sometimes.
It's a lot of people.
Yeah.
Homecoming comes early this year with the theme of the masquerade ball.
We have the coronation assembly, which is always fun. Pep assembly, want to get everyone going, everyone participating, so.
The coronation assembly is Tuesday morning, followed by Warrior Fest after school from 5 to 8 p.m. on the track. There is a $5 fee for unlimited inflatable rides. Food and other activities are cash only.
It's a very fun event where just all the clubs and all these different groups come and they have inflatable rides and beanbag toss and there's all this different stuff and there's food and just to get people out there and to have fun environment and just get your spirit up for the week.
The pep assembly is Friday afternoon, followed by the football game that night against Lake Park.
That's where we have all the fun. That's where we have the cheerleaders, we have palms, every club is kind of doing their thing and getting all the students kind of riled up for homecoming.
Tickets for Saturday's dance will be on sale Monday through Friday during lunch hours. The dance begins at 7 p.m. and runs until 10 p.m.
I mean, obviously it's homecoming dance, so it's just going to be a fun place to go. We have great decorations, working on it. I know all the seniors, and I'm sure everyone else is just dedicated to trying to get the best homecoming dance we can. And then, we have a new DJ, so that'll be interesting. I know he's going to be doing stuff with lights and videos and stuff like that, so that'll draw some more people in. And also, there is a little bit of a surprise at the end, so if people do come, they'll be able to see what happens at the end, and that'll be fun.
For Warrior Update, I'm Kylie Clark.
Sunday is the 10th anniversary of the September 11th attacks in New York, Washington, and Pennsylvania. Warrior Update takes a look back to see how America has recovered and progressed since then.
It's been almost 10 years since September 11th, 2001, when two hijacked planes slammed into the World Trade Center. One plane crashed into the Pentagon building, while one plane crashed into an open field in Pennsylvania. We sat down with Mr. Detella to talk about how far America has come since that tragic day.
Well, 9/11, it was Al-Qaeda attacking us. Al-Qaeda had their base in Afghanistan. Obviously, we went to war with Afghanistan. We've taken the Taliban out of power. Al-Qaeda is not very functional in that region. Taking out bin Laden, taking out several of the other leaders of Al-Qaeda in that region has destabilized it. We are safer because the war's on terrorism, because they don't need to come to America to attack Americans. We're going to them.
Detella is using 9/11 as a teaching tool in his military history class, applying strategies to real-life situations.
It'll be pretty close to the start of our strategy unit, so we'll address strategically what do we need to do, what do we need to continue doing, where are our vulnerabilities. When someone wants to attack you, you're always vulnerable. How vulnerable you are is how well you defend against it. And obviously, we've not cut money from the military. We're still actively pursuing that. We've organized our homeland security a little bit better.
As time moves on, newer generations are less likely to be affected or even remember 9/11, making it something in the history books.
It was a good example. They remember where they were when 9/11 happened. Oh, I was in third grade, or I was in eighth grade. Now that Mr. D, I was, you know, not even in, I was in kindergarten. And so they're losing. They never had that emotional connection, that response, that vivid memory. And so making that connection is harder. Just like with anything in history, how do you make it relevant to them?
To tell us as America can win the war on terror, but that the U.S. will always have to be on guard.
You're attacking an organization. You're attacking an idea. It moves. It's very fluid. And that's something that you're always going to have to keep on. Sure, if we aggressively pursue it, we can destroy Al-Qaeda. You go after their money, you go after their leadership, so they become less effective at planning and developing operations, so they can't carry out big strikes against us.
For Warrior Update, Dina Abdallah.
That's all for Warrior Update. I'm Max Kaczynski. Thanks for watching.